Another question that we have is from Joel, who's watching from Germany. Why do people have different abilities? Some are clever, some are good at some things and not so good at other things. And does that mean that people have more spirit and some people have less spirit? And if this spirit is measurable, I mean, maybe it's not measurable, then why do we see so much variation in life?
Look, we agree with Darwin. Hinduism agrees with the idea that all of us have come out of a single cell being and gone through a whole series of different lives as insects, as animals, and so on. And we carry a lot of baggage. Sometimes it's counterproductive to our own progress. Sometimes it is helpful. So it's not that you deserve something better or worse. It's simply that the journey that you've taken, the trajectory that you've adopted in a way brings in a lot of baggage. So sometimes some people appear very dull, difficult, and some appear very sharp. It's just, if you like, good luck that they have come through a trajectory which has allowed them to kind of become very kind of well focused and more advanced. Doesn't mean somebody is higher or lower. Simply everybody is making their own journey, and sometimes they go through a difficult patch. And again, there is we agree that the thing that is manifesting from in all of us is the pure, pristine spirit, you know, infinite power. And yet, when it tries to express itself through this very kind of limited mind and body structure, in a way, it kind of pays a price and becomes embroiled in what the mind, the body, the intellect tells him. And that, in a way, reduces his capacity. Everybody is essentially spiritual. They've got the potential of expressing this infinite power they possess. But unfortunately, the encasement they have, in a way, restricts the way they express themselves. So we have to be aware of that.